Florida is a silent poem of color and light. Florida is a dreamland. No other region of our great country can compare with it. It is always alluring and full of enchantment in its natural state. Whenever you have gained a firm foothold, its magic charm will not let you loose again. These most beautiful and charming landscape pictures should be held sacred.
These words, expressed by Henry Nehrling more than 100 years ago, capture the deepest feelings of all of us who live in his dreamland. Feelings once shared by the earliest settlers, and now by the 1,200 plus new residents who stream into Florida on a daily basis. Who was this man who developed such a love for Florida's unique tropical and native landscape? We only have to look back to the late 1800s to discover Nehrling's contribution to Florida's plant industry. Born in Wisconsin, Henry Nehrling was a horticulturalist, ornithologist, educator, and writer. In 1885, he was seeking land where he could pursue his passion for the study of tropical and subtropical plants. He purchased 40 acres of Dreamland in the small German-American settlement of Gotha, near Orlando. What Nehrling saw was the essence of Florida's natural magic. Like many of us, Nehrling knew he was in paradise. His words express the gratitude of that knowledge.
It is a unique, wonderful magic that exists in this sandy, sunny, ocean-surrounded Florida. It's hard to explain something that has to be felt in the innermost soul and is hard to describe. Everything is green and blooming in this seemingly flat terrain. Enthusiasm of a special kind and key poetic feeling enters our soul when we traverse the state north to south.
Nehrling's commitment to Florida's plant introduction, cultivation, and observation culminated in Palm Cottage Gardens, which would become, according to a University of Florida professor in 1925, a mecca for horticulturalists who came to Florida, as well as the perpetual source of wonder to the nurserymen of Florida who were lucky enough to visit it. Here in Central Florida, Nehrling developed the first U.S. Department of Agriculture experimental station. According to a quarantine officer of the time, he was not content with the offerings of the Florida commercial growers, ignoring the fact that he already had under observation probably 10 times as many kinds of plants as all the commercial growers. At his 40-acre garden, he evaluated and cultivated more than 3,000 new varieties of ornamental plants, such as bromeliads, bamboos, cycads, palms, as well as many Florida native plants. He introduced over 300 new plant species, such as crinum lilies, amaryllis, and caladiums. Nehrling was the father of caladium farming. Today, caladiums are a $13 million business, while horticulture is one of Florida's leading industries. For 43 years, Dr. Nehrling experimented with practically every type of growing plant shipped from ports, ranging from Brazil to Hong Kong. Many of the treasured tropical and native plants we seek for our own lush gardens, such as the popular landscape plant Indian hawthorn, have root in Nehrling's garden. We have only to step into our yards to feel the impact of Nehrling's genius and the legacy of his life's work. His vision and research earned him national prominence and the admiration of other horticulturalists and naturalists. Theodore Roosevelt, who esteemed conservation as a critical source of American wealth, was only one of the thousands of visitors who marveled at the garden and celebrated Nehrling's tireless work in the early 1900s. other luminaries who visited this early Florida tourist attraction included John Burroughs, Theodore Mead, Thomas Edison, Henry Ford, Harvey Firestone, Liberty Hyde Bailey, the founder of Cornell University's College of Agriculture, and Dr. David Fairchild, the famous botanical explorer. Dr. Nehrling was also a consultant to Thomas Edison when Edison, Ford, and Firestone were interested in deriving rubber from ficus plants and plants containing lactic fluid. Dr. Nehrling was a frequent lecturer at Rollins College, and he was given the Meyer Medal for his distinguished service in the field of foreign plant introduction. Since his death in 1929, booming local development has tragically dwindled Nehrling's 40-acre garden, with only 6 acres in the original homestead remaining. Ironically, Nehrling and other Florida pioneers made possible the economic opportunities that today threaten the home and remaining garden that was his legacy. How will we grow? Will we protect this remaining cultural landscape? Or will we lose it all to development? Valiant efforts are being made to save this treasure, to sustain a portion of Florida's pioneer heritage and natural beauty. In 1999, the Henry Nehrling Society was created by a group of concerned citizens to preserve Dr. Nehrling's home and horticultural legacy. Among the first accomplishments was recording the site on the National Register of Historic Places and creating a nonprofit organization. The Society's mission for Nehrling Gardens is historic preservation, horticultural education, and environmental conservation. The Society plans to preserve the home as an education center, featuring exhibits on the horticultural history of Central Florida, as well as on the history of the early pioneer German-American community of Gotha, settled in 1885. Classes on sustainable gardening and landscaping practices will focus on appropriate tropical and native plant selection, water conservation, and lakeshore restoration. Through programs and classes, we will teach both homeowners and children to value and nurture Florida's unique and fragile ecology. Visitors will enjoy a new resource library, educational displays of tropical and native plants, woodland and demonstration gardens, and a wildlife observation boardwalk. Even now, the garden features a diverse tropical and hardwood tree canopy over 100 years old, a greenhouse, walking paths, and areas to relax. A garden where one can again experience the beauty and tranquility of nature as Nehrling did more than 100 years ago. Your help is needed to ensure that this unique and historical cultural landscape is saved for the benefit of all of us. We have the wisdom and the power to preserve this living legacy, to effect change in the way we use our natural resources, to educate and empower our youth to become good stewards of the earth. Once this opportunity is gone, we cannot recreate it. We must not allow this opportunity to slip through our fingers. Will we act upon it? Or will we waste this priceless inheritance? Preserving Nehrling Gardens is a long-term investment in retaining the historic, physical, and economic value of our dreamland and the very quality of our lives. Over 100 years ago, Dr. Nehrling wrote about Florida's dreamland.
The most beautiful and charming landscape pictures should be held sacred. Many of our glorious dense hammocks surrounding our clear water lakes and bordering our dreamy watercourses should be kept intact for future generations. It is high time, therefore, that steps be taken to preserve what still remains.
Please support the Henry Nehrling Society by giving generously of your donations and your time. Learn how your efforts today will educate our children and generations to come about Florida pioneer history, horticulture, and environmental conservation.
My garden, more natural than artistic, is my paradise. No words can express the delights and pleasures, the enthusiasm and inspiration it affords. Here I find rest and tranquility. Here I find peace and happiness.